October is Holy Ghost Month. KB is having a concert for the youth and young adults. So, if you have a young adult, if you have a youth, if they're still living in your house, get them to the building. This concert is an outreach, so therefore it is free. But we are wanting to see people who are never, ever been exposed to Jesus. Many will be saved on this night. It's going to be an incredible time of worship and hip-hopping. So, don't miss any of these events. God bless you, and we'll see you in October.
Hi, church family. I'm Ashley Tate, one of the pastors here at The Way. And here we have our November theme. Our theme for that month is abundant living, and we're going to be talking about the life that God has given us. Jesus paid the price for us to live life more abundantly is what the word says. And so we're going to learn about that together. We're going to bring our gifts to the Father, to the Lord, and to our church so that we can continue in giving to this community in abundance, giving to the world in abundance through our church and through what God is doing here. So during the month of November, on the 7th and the 12th, so that Tuesday and Sunday, is our Holy Warriors launch. If you have been considering getting involved with our discipleship classes, we have Holy Warriors 1, 2, and 3. Please get on the app, get online. You can join and register today for that. So on the 18th, which is a Saturday, we have our Thanksgiving community dinner. And that will be happening at our Arrowhead campus, downtown San Bernardino. We have a great event planned for the community, for families, for children. We have a playground, an amazing playground at that campus that's brand new. We'll have a petting zoo. We'll have all kinds of vendors and fun outside. And then we'll serve a beautiful Thanksgiving meal. So come, sign people up if you know somebody that needs a meal during that time of giving and just loving in our community. That's on the 18th. And then at the end of the month, we have on the 29th, our Holy Warriors Mass Baptism. So if you're signed up for that, we're looking forward to that. Come celebrate those people that are taking the next step in their journey with the Lord and getting baptized. So we look forward to the month of November with you guys. We love you, and we'll see you at church.
Lord, I'm not afraid. So give your blood, you bought off I won't be afraid, 'cause you go be.
Come on, sing it out, enemies.
Enemies surround me.
And mountains above me.
Washed in his blood, and what he did on Calvary, oh. I seek after you, and he heard, and he answered. on, let's put our trust in Him for the circumstances that we're in today. I want you guys to lift your hands in this place. Not only because we're surrendering and we need something from God, but He is worthy of our praise. Amen. He's worthy no matter what we go through. We know that He is worthy in every circumstance. So we give Him our praise. We give Him our all because He is worthy of it. We thank You, Jesus. Hallelujah. We place our trust in You, Father. If I trusted You then while I was under, I can trust You again while in the wonder. Why would I ever want to wander away? How could I ever want to wander away? If I trusted You then while I was under, I can trust You again while in the wonder. Why would I ever want to wander away? Come on, sing that out. If I trusted You then, trust You again while in the wonder. Why would I ever want to wander away? How could I ever want to wander away?
If I trusted You then,
if I trusted You then while I was under, I can trust You again while in the wonder. Why would I ever want to wander away? How could I ever want to wander
if I trusted You then?
If I trusted You then while I was under, I can trust You again while in the wonder.
Up in this place. Let's put our hands up in this place. In an environment of praise and worship like this, God can do anything. When we begin to lift Him up, when we begin to worship Him as we have today, it says in the Bible that He will come and make a home there, that He comes and He dwells. He lives right there in the middle of our praise. And I believe that right now there is a well of healing. There's a well of freedom. There is a river of life available to you right now. If you would just lift your hands and begin to worship Him and exalt Him, Jesus will do something that nobody else can do. Jesus will do what only He can do. So right now, I just want you to begin to praise Him in your own way. Just shout, sing, declare, thank Him for who He is. Jesus, we thank You. We worship You. We exalt You in this place. We thank You that You've never failed us, God, that You never will, that You show up, that You're faithful to be there whenever we praise You. Jesus, there is no one like You. Jesus, we worship You with all of our hearts. We exalt You because we begin to lift Him up. We begin to lift Him up. We begin to lift Him up in this place. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Jesus. One last time, I want you to just give a shout. On the count of three, we're going to shout the name of Jesus. One, two, three, Jesus. All right, right now, in this moment of worship, we're going to do something really special as a church. We're going to invite seven families out here to dedicate their children to the Lord. Would you give it up for our families? These are our families. These are people that you know and love. Pastor Armando and the team are going to dedicate these children to the Lord today. Let's be a part of this moment.
Let's give them a hand as they're coming up here. It's amazing. We have seven families, nine children. I also want to do something else. These people, they brought a whole section of people over there. A lot of them first-time guests. Let's welcome them as well. Thank you, guys. Let's come on in. I want to thank you guys for coming. This is something that we do every month. It's the third Sunday of the month. We do a class, a training to dedicate these children. And then today, we now dedicate them in front of the church, saying that, guess what? Just like this family that showed up here, they have a church family that's going to support to build and raise these children, right? The Bible says in Psalms 127 that kids are a gift from the Lord. And we're believing that these kids are going to make an impact in the world in the next generation as they're raised in the house of God. So let's give them a hand as they're here. I'm up here with Sam. Come on up. Sam and Judy are our child dedication leaders. Tell us a little bit what we're going to be doing today.
Absolutely. What an honor it is to be up here with this beautiful family. Just seeing what God is doing in each and every one of them. And I'm just so honored to be a part of it because these families have dedicated and partnered up and made a covenant with our Lord Jesus Christ to raise their children up in the way of the Lord. So when they grow up, they will not depart. So I just give them a round of hand again. You know, just an awesome moment for each and every one of them.
Judy's going to go ahead and introduce all of the family and their kids. So Judy, if you'd go ahead.
All right. So first up right here in this beautiful green dress, we have the Urquidez family with little Aleya right here. And then we have the Escalante Rodriguez family. We have baby Christina right here and little Noah. And then we have the Ulloa family with Zeke and Zeus. And the Esparza family with Itzel. And the Edwards-Anderson family with Soleil. And the Lara family with baby Lily right here. And the Reyes family with baby Jesus.
Awesome. Now, each one of these kids are going to get a certificate and their very first Bible signed by Pastor Marco. So they're going to learn the Word of God. And they're going to be able to teach the Word of God when they get older. So let's pray for each one of them. We're going to anoint them. And as we pray with them, we want you guys to stretch your arms forward. Pray for them like these were your children. Remember, we're doing this together. We're family. Let's pray. Father, we just lift up every one of these children, Father, and these fathers and mothers, Father. We thank you, Lord, that as they showed up today, Father, you're showing up in every one of their lives. You're blessing them. You're giving them wisdom, guidance, Lord. We thank you that these children will make an impact in the world, Father. We've seen amazing youth ministry yesterday, Father. There'll be youth pastors. There'll be people in our community, teachers, Father, that would be strengthened and empowered with the Word of God to go out and touch and transform lives, Father. We thank you, Lord, that as they are here today, Father, they will grow up in this house. They will be planted and they will flourish, Father, in the community, in every area, Lord, that they go to, Father. We thank you, Lord, for the parents, Lord, that they'll raise them up, Father, in your word. And Father, we thank you, Lord, that as they're surrounded with your presence, Father, we're going to see an overflow in their children and in the generations to come. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Awesome. I want to thank you guys for supporting these families. Again, if you want your children or your child to be dedicated, I met a grandparent today. They're like, we're here today because our grandbaby is getting baptized. If you want your kids to get dedicated, your child to get dedicated, we do this November 19th, and then the dedication will be November 26th. Let's give them a hand again. Thank you guys so much. God bless you guys.
Awesome. Come on, we can do better than that. Let's give these families one more round of applause. Thank God for what he's doing. You know, these families are now part of our family because when you come once, you are now part of the family. Would you take a moment to greet somebody on your way back to your seats today? Just tell someone you're glad to see them. Give them a hug, a high five, a handshake. If you're watching online, we are so glad that you tuned in today. We pray you're experiencing the same power and presence of God in your home, in your workplace, in your car, wherever you may be tuning in, as we are right here at Hallmark Campus. It's an exciting time to be at our church. Things are moving and shaking. You're going to be hearing more about some of the exciting stuff that's already taken place here at the church just this last week
in a few minutes when Pastor Christian comes to share. But I do want to just take a moment to go through a couple of exciting upcoming events. Someone say upcoming. So first thing, today. Someone say today. Today is the day for our membership class. If we'd like to make it official and become an official member of the Wayworld Outreach Church, right after service, after the 11 o'clock service at 1:15 in the South Hall, we'd like you to join us. Come make it official, learn about the history of our church, get to meet Pastor Marco, take a picture with him and some of the other staff, and of course, learn about your role in the future. We want you to be a part of our family. We are so glad that you are, and get this, we'll provide lunch, so don't miss our membership class today at 1:15 in the South Hall. The next thing is tonight, we have a couple cool things happening. I'm just going to mention them quickly. One is that we have an all-church prayer meeting taking place in the South Hall at 6 o'clock. And for those of you who didn't get a chance to see it this last Sunday, our Crossroads cinematic production kicked off last week in Pomona. It was unbelievable. People literally filled the place out. It was decked out. People were walking by saying, how much do I have to pay to get in here to our church? And it was awesome. Hundreds were there and many were saved. And we want you to know that there's another opportunity tonight, and it's going to be very, very tight. I don't know how many seats are available, but you can show up tonight for Crossroads in Pomona campus again. Next Friday is also, someone say next Friday. Next Friday, that's this coming Friday, we have Unity Night with Pastor Gavin speaking to our men, and Pastor Yesenia De La Rosa will be speaking to the women. Come on, wait, ladies, where are you at? All right. It's going to be good. We want you to be a part of that Friday night at 7 o'clock. Now, next Sunday, there's also, somebody say next Sunday. Next Sunday, you have two major events coming up. The first is that we are releasing eight principles to experience the abundant life. Someone say abundant. I don't know if you had the opportunity to get this book when we did just the first four principles last year, but this is the complete edition with all eight principles that on how to experience the abundant life. I love this quote from Pastor Marco, if I can bring it up. This is what this book is all about. It's going to teach you godly principles, but listen to this quote. Having an abundant life is not an accident, but it is achieved through the application of godly principles that are guaranteed to produce success. I'm going to say guaranteed. If someone was offering you a book that guaranteed to produce success, would you want that book? Yeah, absolutely. And this book is going to be released next Sunday. And to get this, it's a very low cost, just $10 for all of the principles. So make sure you get ready for that book. Also want to mention something unbelievable to me. I actually just came back from vacation. Let me tell you, I've been all over the world over the last week or so. And I said, there's no place I would rather be than right here with my Wayward Outreach family. Me and my wife are so happy to be back. But get this, guys, this church is blowing up in so many ways. And one of the most amazing things is that people, world influencers, with millions and millions of people following them, are showing up here just like last night, which you're going to hear more about. But in just 1 week's time, Barack, which is one of the most influential, world-renowned Spanish worship teams in the world, they're going to be here on Sunday night. And get this, we've already almost sold all of the 2,000 or so tickets. I think it was almost 2,000 tickets we had available, and 135 tickets are all that's left. So make sure you get on Boletos Express today, right now, and buy those tickets. I'm telling you what, they're going to be gone if you want to be here. So one final thing I want to introduce is just a video that's going to share a little bit about Holy Warriors coming up. Holy Warriors is our discipleship growth track. Someone say growth. We want you to grow here at our church, and we've invested in some amazing classes. Holy Warriors 1, 2, and 3, they're launching a week from Tuesday. Check this out, and then you'll see a testimony, and we'll be right back.
Control of your past. That's how you used to be. You used to be under control of the devil, but Jesus set you free. So now you can get some self-control. Give God some praise. We can overcome this. Trapped with someone's mouth. I'm not going to be trapped with an offender. I'm going places, and I'm not going to be a prisoner of war.
Hi, how you doing? My name is Victor Viramontes, and I've been coming to the Way Church for 2 months now. Last year, I lost a lot of people in my family just due to different complications. I was losing everything. I was losing my mom, my grandma, my uncles. My girlfriend broke up with me. I was feeling like there was going to be nothing left for me, you know? My ex invited me, and because we were breaking up, she was breaking up with me, she invited me as a friend to come check this out. She thought I would get a lot out of it because I was going through a rough time. I got saved when I came here. It was like extraordinary. It was amazing. As soon as I came in, I felt like there was hope. There wasn't the end of the road for me. You know, I felt like I was gonna be able to get over everything, you know, with the help of a good team here. I was never able to truly heal from them because I was hiding from my grief. It allowed me to handle that head on, and at this moment right now, I feel amazing. I feel like I can finally move forward and accept the losses that I have had. The best advice I can give for somebody going through my situation is to trust in the Lord. Everything happens for a reason, and it's never to hurt you. Nothing's ever to hurt you. It's always for you to learn off of any kind of situation that comes your way. I'm more caring towards my dad now, more or so, because he's the only one left in my life right now. Losing everybody, it gives you an opportunity to mend relationships with anybody, friends, family, or anybody that you might not have thought, I'm gonna lose them tomorrow, I'm gonna lose them the next week. It's something that you need to, make amends, and you know, for everybody and everybody that you've hurt, and even people that have hurt you, you need to try to make it right because nobody's promised tomorrow. I was a broken man before. I was broken, lost, didn't know what I was doing. But now I look forward to every single day of my life. I'm blessed to have this day, to even finish this day, to keep on moving, to not live in pain. I'm free now, and I'm happy.
Come on, can we give God praise for that? What an awesome statement he said there. I'm blessed to have every day of my life. Just even that attitude of gratitude and being thankful for everything that he has. And how many, by show of hands, you could say, you know, I have something to be thankful for. I have something to be thankful for. I think we can all say we have something that we could be thankful for. You know, I'm especially thankful because we've been able to do so much as a church this past week. And I want to highlight with you just a few things that we've been able to see. This is in just 1 week, okay? 1 week as a church, what we've been able to do. Check this out. Just last Sunday, we launched our Crossroads drama at the Pomona campus. Come on. This was exciting. We had probably, I don't know how many hundreds of people were in there, but over 100 people gave their life to the Lord. It was probably 25% of the whole room gave their life to Jesus that night. Give God some praise for that. Souls are getting saved in Pomona. It's really exciting to see. Then we also had our youth department here at the church have been doing such an amazing job. They went out to Summit High School and did a rally at the lunchtime in a public school, had over 600 teens show up to their rally at lunchtime. And you want to know what's cool? Over 500 of them gave their life to Jesus at a school lunch. Come on. And this rally was actually not even the main thing. This was actually leading up to an awesome youth and young adult concert that happened last night in this building. Thousands of people showed up last night in this room and gave their life to Jesus. Come on, give God some praise. This is happening right now at our church. We had teens from all over California. We had people driving from Redding, California. We had people from all over, and so many came and were blessed and gave their life to Jesus. So give God some praise for that. And then not just that, but we had the young adults take over Cal State San Bernardino this past Friday. The young adults were at Cal State San Bernardino on Friday doing a pop-up where they were preaching the gospel, doing praise and worship, loving people. And we actually had a young man, his name was Akeem, and he was invited And Hakeem came and he shared his story with everybody. And he said, I just want to say thank you for inviting me. He said, today and that night on Friday is my 21st birthday. He said, I was an atheist. But right now, I just want to say thank you because I feel like I have hope now. And this is literally what he said. I have hope now. I want to thank you for introducing me to God. Thank you so much. And he was an atheist and he gave his life to Jesus at Cal State San Bernardino. Come on, give God some praise for that. Another highlight, on Wednesday night, we launched at our Arrowhead campus. They launched their Wednesday night service at our Arrowhead campus. Guys, just a reminder, this is all in 1 week. Just see what God can do when we come together in faith and we believe and we sow seed. Everything you're seeing, all these souls getting saved, all this ministry happening, that's the harvest of every seed that we put in the ground here. And every time we invest and every time we love and every time we give, we are seeing more and more and more and more of these God stories happening all over our city and all over the world. There's a scripture in Proverbs chapter 11, verse 24. This is an NLV version. It says, there is one who is free in giving. There's a person who gives freely. They don't hold back. And this is what happens to them. It says, yet he grows richer. So you give and you give and you give what you have, but you still just keep getting richer. That's what the Bible's saying. This famous quote from Anne Frank. This is a great quote. It says, no one has ever become poor by giving. No one has ever become poor by giving. But look at the second part of the scripture. It says, and there is one, there's another, who keeps what he should give, but he ends up needing more. You know what the principle is here in the scripture? There's one person that gives freely, and all they're saying is this: okay, God, I'm going to trust you. I'm going to trust you more than my bank account. I'm going to trust you more than my situation. God, I'm going to trust you more than my job. We know the economy goes crazy. Jobs go crazy. We've seen the pandemic a couple years ago. Everything, the world can shake up in a moment. There's one person we can always trust, we can always depend on, and that is God. How many believe that today? So let's trust God. Let's not trust anything else. And this is a promise from God. When you give, he makes sure that there's more in your hands. Here's another promise. When you give, there's people out there that are saying, thank you, thank you, thank you for giving. So let's give today with a cheerful heart, knowing that we're sowing seed in other people's lives and in our own and in our families. How many are ready to give today? Let's do that. There's three ways we can do that. We can sow seed in the house. We can sow seed in ministry. The first is by downloading the Way World Outreach app. This is a great app to have. You have sermons and other things, but you can set up giving that way. It's very easy. Second way, you go to this website, theway.gives. Type in that website, theway.gives, and follow the instructions from there. Or the third way is right here in person. There are kiosks all over the room. And if you want to just flag down one of the ushers and get an envelope, you can give right that way and just fill it out. And you can drop it off in the kiosk. Well, let's pray. And as we do this song of worship, we're going to use this song of worship to worship in our giving. Who's ready to give today? Who's ready? Let's do it. Let's pray. God, we thank you so much for all the ministry, all the souls, these young men, these young women, these people that are being saved, these teens in the high school. Lord, those are our children. Those are our brothers and sisters. These are our fathers and our mothers that are being impacted. And God, we sow this seed in faith, believing that you're going to reach our families as well. We trust you, God, with our finances. And we know that when we give to you, we don't end up in lack. We end up all the richer. We end up with more. So bless everyone as they give and bless the ministry and let it see a harvest of souls. In Jesus' name we pray. We all say amen. All right, let's worship God in our giving. God bless.
morning, everyone. This moment can change your life forever. Now, never does God or Jesus show up anywhere without a mission, a vision to help people, to save them, to heal them. We see Jesus everywhere he goes. People were healed, they were set free, and impossible things became possible. Miracles happened everywhere he went. Now, the Bible says that he went to his hometown, and that was the toughest crowd. How many know sometimes the hardest people to reach are the people closest to you, right? And he went to his hometown, and the Bible says that he couldn't do a lot of miracles there because of their unbelief. This is what they were doing was talking themselves out of a breakthrough, a healing, a miracle. They needed it, but they talked themselves out of it. What you say to yourself matters a whole bunch. You'll never have a great life if your self-talk is full of negativity. Now I know that some of us grew up in a really negative situation, negative homes, and you might still be in a negative environment, but this is what the easy thing to do is reflect your environment. But God doesn't want you to reflect your environment. He wants you to change your environment. Now, your environment changes when your perspective changes, when your mindset changes. And I'll say this, your self-talk changes. Our greatest enemy is not the devil. Your greatest enemy is not your wife or your husband. Your greatest enemy is not your neighbor. Your greatest enemy is you. And if you don't overcome you, this is what's going to happen. You'll keep getting in your way of succeeding, having a great life, having great relationships. But there's a problem. You'll blame everyone around you. Because until you start taking personal responsibility, I'm in the mess I'm in because of the decisions I'm making, the way I'm thinking. But the good news is you can change your thinking, change your perspective, change your self-talk, and then change your life. It can happen. So the Bible says that they were saying, this is what they're saying when Jesus walked into their town. They were saying, oh, we know who he is. He's the son of Joseph and Mary, and we know his brothers and his sisters. We know them. And they were almost offended about him. And crazy. And this is what could happen in a moment like this. I just can't wait to get out of church. I just came and I'm here. What are we going to eat for lunch? And you're missing the moment. And this moment can change your family, change your destiny, change your children, change your emotions. It can set you free. Come on. How many know if Jesus is here, because he is here, his presence is here, and his word's going to be spoken. But the beginning process is to allow yourself to let go of that negativity and just get in the moment. Get in this moment. If there's one thing you can learn, we come to church to worship God. We sang a few songs, and now we're going to study the Bible. And this is a pattern we've seen every time the Bible is taught anywhere. Lives are changed forever. We could go into Cal State San Bernardino and just cover a few scriptures. An atheist turns into a believer and gets set free from a spirit of depression, hopelessness, and suicide. Isn't that amazing? And we're seeing this happen everywhere. So today, we're going to study a few scriptures here. And we're going to be talking about winning the battle within. And every one of us have a battle within yourself. And what I mean by that, there's thoughts that like try to invade and take over your life and take over your emotions. And the problem is, if you don't learn how to overcome that, it will become you. It will destroy you. Some of us have thoughts of depression, thoughts of the past, thoughts of our failures. And we're thinking, man, can I ever overcome that? Because it seems like it's me. I'm stuck. And the good news is you can overcome the battle within you. You can overcome the anger within you, the jealousy within you, the depression within you, the fear within you, the addiction within you, the cycles of destruction you've been in within you, the thoughts that you're worth nothing, you could overcome that, the rejection that you've experienced. Today could be a brand new day. And this is what happens when you get a victory in you. This is what's so great about it. You can now be a conduit for victory for others. This is what God says. I'm not going to give you a victory just to give you a victory. I'm going to make you more than a conqueror. You know what more than conqueror is? That you got victory, and you got so much victory, you can start handing out some hope. You can start handing out some breakthrough. You can start, you can say this, I received it, now I can give it. How many are ready to receive a victory, walk in victory, so you can start giving that to the people around you? And you might be thinking, man, you don't know my family. My family is really crazy, and I get it. I know my family, all our families are a little crazy, right? And that's just reality. But God puts your crazy self in it to get some healing so you can help your crazy family. How many were out there? Your friends, your family. But where does a breakthrough her family begins with you? It's called the domino effect. Boom, 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 boom. Let's get everybody else. If you let God get you, okay? So we're going to be talking about winning this battle within, and every single person on earth has this battle, and this is what happens. If you don't overcome this, it will overcome you. You'll become so depressed, you'll want to die, you'll self-medicate, you'll just get drugs, drinking, you'll go from one relationship to the other relationship, you'll try one thing and try the other, but it doesn't fix you. There's only one that can fix inside of you, and his name's Jesus Christ. So I want you to know that. That's the only way to get fixed and whole. So let's pray, and then we'll study a few scriptures, and maybe you can relate. Father, we just thank you for this time that we have to study the word. And as we're studying the word, help us to hear it, understand it. And this is the greatest healing. This is the greatest therapy. Because this, Father, this healing that you give, you said you come to heal broken hearts. You're the one that does internal surgery and make us new. Father, you know what every one of us are going through. And you're not intimidated by our situation. Because every situation we're facing, you can help us overcome. Today we open ourselves up to you, and we're saying, Lord, we're open. Teach us, lead us, fill us with your spirit, make us new. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. You may be seated. Overcoming, or winning the battle within. Say with me, winning the battle within. Every one of us has an internal battle. And there's a man in the Bible called the Apostle Paul. And he wrote the majority of the New Testament. And he began to describe the battle that he had within himself. And as we read this portion of scripture, maybe you could relate and say, well, yeah, that's me too. I could see that. And this is a guy that wrote the majority of the New Testament. And this is what he said in Romans chapter 7. We're going to read verse 14. Verse 15, 18, 19, and 24 and 25. This is what it says. The trouble, this is what he said, is with me. For I am all too human, a slave to sin. What he was saying is, I'm making some bad decisions, but I'm not only making bad decisions, it seems like it's those bad decisions have taken over and made me a slave, or I can't break the cycle. Is there anything in your life that you said, man, I never want to do that again, and you find yourself doing it again? You find yourself blowing up, and you have these anger fits, and you say, man, I'm so sorry I did that, but you keep getting angry, like I'm a slave to sin. Is there any time you said, New Year's resolutions, I'm going to stop doing this, and you find yourself doing it again? And again and again. But it's not just something that's been with you for a year or a couple months or a year. It's actually been following you, and it's been a decade. It's been maybe two decades. It's been years, and it's not getting better. It seems like it's getting worse. And you could say, I can stop anytime I want. How come you don't? And I'll tell you why you don't. Because anything you give yourself to, you become addicted to. So if you give yourself to bad, you get addicted to bad. See, every sin that me and you commit comes with chains. And there's only one chain breaker, and his name is Jesus Christ. And you're saying, man, if I want to get set free. So Paul is talking about this slavery. And he goes, man, I'm stuck. But look what he says. I don't really understand myself. Anybody there? I want to do what is right, but I don't do it. Instead, I do what I hate. But I've seen that happen over and over. There's people in this room that you almost hate your mama. Or you hate someone in your family that really hurt you. And that hate is crazy. It's taking over your life. And this is the worst part. You're becoming like your mama. Because what you hate, you become like. That's why hate is so, it's destructive, because it takes over your life. And this is, see, people might hurt you, but you got to be very careful that you don't get trapped by their hurt. Because if you get trapped by their hurt, it's kind of like you get contaminated by their poison and you become just like them. Can you relate? I do what I hate. Verse 18. And I know that nothing good lives in me. That is my sinful nature. I want to do what is right, but I can't. Now, it describes something here. It's introducing a subject, a sinful nature. We'll go deeper into that. And another way to say it is human nature. Another way to say that is lustful nature. And this is a nature that desires what God forbids. It's a nature that urges us to do what's wrong. And that's why the porn sites are so successful in attracting a clientele, because every one of us have a sinful nature, and our sinful nature is a lustful nature, and it loves it, and we're attracted to it. But the problem is, you're attracted to it, and then it traps you. You're married and you're flirting with somebody. You know what that is? Your human sinful nature. I want my wife, but I want a girl on the side. I love my wife. I just want a side dish. You know what that is? Your sinful nature. This is my last drink, because last week you got drunk and crashed your brand new car. And you say, this is it. I'm not going to do it again. And you do it again and again and again, and it's getting worse. You know what's happening? Your sinful nature is taking over. You cuss out everybody. This is the last time I'm going to get angry like that. You break your dishes. You stab your own tires in your wife's car. Cuss everybody out. And then after the commotion, the tornado, you say, oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. I'll never do it again. And you do it again. Why? You have a sinful nature. And every one of us have a sinful nature. You know what it's called? A human nature. You cannot let your life be defined by your lower nature. And I got good news for you. We all have a lower nature, but God has given us a way to overcome our lower nature and live out a new nature, which is His nature, that gives us power to overcome every sin. Someone say we could overcome. Can I overcome it? Yeah, you could overcome whatever you need to overcome. You can do it. But Paul is describing this problem. I want to do what's good, but I don't. I don't want to do what is wrong, but I do it anyway. Interesting. Verse 24. Oh, that, what a miserable person I am. Who will free me from this life that is dominated by sin and death? And this idea of sin and death, say with me, sin and death. The idea is, this is the idea. You cannot do what's wrong and get right results. So there's a right way to do things, there's a wrong way to do it. And if you do it wrong, and there's a lot of young people that, you know, it didn't work out for the parents doing it wrong. And then your parents are telling you, I did what you did, it didn't work. Learn from my bad example. And then the young person might say this, you live your life, let me live my life. So that's the conversation. The idea is this, I'm not gonna mess up like you. I'm gonna do the wrong choices, but it's gonna work out for me. That's why the prisons are full. I mean, you're saying that. That's why we're heartbroken. That's why our lives are out of order. But I got good news. If your life's out of order, there's a God that can put it back in order. But it begins with you admitting, my life is out of order. Stop. You see, you'll never get help until you start talking like Paul here, like I'm out of control. I do it. Oh, what a miserable person I am. Who will free me from this life that is dominated by sin and death? Now, the word death means sin and death come together. Say it with me. Sin and death go together. It's like hamburgers and fries, like peanut butter and jelly. This is what it's saying is the end result of planting a tomato seed is you get tomatoes. The end result of planting a seed or taking action on a sin, at the end, it produces death. Now, this word death is a Hebrew word, and it's pronounced thanatos. Even sounds evil. It sounds like Satan. Thanatos. I mean, when you say it like that. But thanatos, and what it means is the misery that arises in a soul because of sin. Now, sin will eventually lead, one of the consequences is misery. Your joy will die, your peace will die, and it's going to be replaced with extreme unhappiness. Right now, the number one cause for disability in the United States, America, and the world is depression. The more ungodly we become, the more depressed we will be. We cannot live a life of sin and be extremely happy. Sin offers you temporary happiness, but leaves you with long-term depression and long-term extreme unhappiness. Now, what do you do with your extreme unhappiness? Well, you try to self-medicate. This is what we do. Well, what I need is another wife. I need another husband. You know why I'm divorcing you? You're not making me happy. I gotta go. You know what I need right now? I need to go into debt. I need to buy myself something to make myself feel better. You know what I need to do? What I need right now is I just need a little weed. A little weed will solve my problem. It doesn't solve your problem. All it does is cover up your depression. It doesn't heal you of your depression. You don't need to get drunk. You don't need to get high. You don't need another person. What you need is an experience with the only one that can make you whole. And Paul is saying, I got a problem and I don't know what to do with it. Now, this is our reality. I remember there was a time that I was super jealous. And I don't know if you've ever experienced a green monster of jealousy. It is a monster, right? And what the problem with jealousy, it makes you a slave, and it takes over every thought you got. I would wake up in the morning, and the first thought in my mind is, and this is when I was going out with Lisa before we got married, and I was thinking, I got to ask her a question. And a stupid question is, did you ever love anybody else? Right? So there's no way to win that, right? She says, yes, I did. Oh, so you gave your love to others. What do you have left for me? And if she says no, I go, you are lying. So I'm the first guy. You just tell me what I want to hear, girl. So it didn't matter. Every morning I had a question. And then I thought if I went to her, she could solve my problem by answering it in a way that would make the jealousy go away. But all it did was, when she answered it, I had 10 more questions. I was going to interrogate her. And she would hate it because I was an interrogator. And there's no way she could win the argument. I'd get it to the point she's crying, and I'd say, okay, I'm sorry. And then I would come to church, and I'd say, God, help me with this. And then I'd do it again. And I'd ask her another question. The idea here is I needed someone to set me free from the jealousy, and it wasn't me, and it wasn't her. Come on, it's not going to be your husband. It's not going to be your wife. It's not going to be the next president of the United States. The only one that could set you free is not going to be your money. It's not going to be a promotion at your job. There's only one that could cause you to win that internal battle, and his name's Jesus. And when you're strong on the inside, you're strong. Is that right? You know, if you're here for the first time, the reality is when you study the Bible, it's true. You can't even argue with it. We all have a sinful nature. We're all human. We all struggle. We all have a battle within each one of us. There's certain things about our lives that we hate, and we keep doing it over and over. This is a struggle, but I got good news. This battle can be won with a lot of help. But look at this. Death, 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 misery, suffering, extreme happiness. But it also means, death also means separation from God and his blessings. Death also means this, ruin and destruction. That means when you're living a life of sin, I could tell your future. It's not because I'm a prophet. I could tell your future because when you're making wrong decisions, this is what I know is in your future. You're going to ruin and destroy everything. Your family's going to be destroyed. Your mind's going to be destroyed. Your body's going to be destroyed. Your children are going to be destroyed. And they're going to be destroyed because sin is leading you and God isn't. Wrong choices always lead to death. And right choices lead to success. They lead to victory. They lead to happiness. So when God's giving you his word, he's not trying to control you. He's trying to lead you to what you desire. Come on. How many know every one of us want to be happy? Come on. Who wants to be happy up in here? Now, you want to be happy. But the idea, you're not going to be happy making wrong decisions. And this is where the devil comes in. He offers you happy pills. He offers you cheese and you're the rat. But everything he offers you comes with temporary relief. And what it does, it traps you, it destroys you, and it ruins your life. And that's why the Bible says, he who builds his house on the rock, when the storms come and the rains come and the pressure hits, the house stays standing. The one who builds his house on the rock is the one that hears the teachings of Jesus and he does them. Now there's another one that builds his house on sand. He hears the teachings of Jesus. He hears what's being spoken today. He lets it go in one ear, out the other. And this person, when the pressure comes, because understand, everybody goes through pressure. Everybody goes through pain. Everybody goes through loss. Everybody goes through difficulty. There's not a person that doesn't. But when that happens, the person that hears the word and doesn't do it, this person's life ends. And it ends in ruin, destruction, everything collapses. This is what happens at the end of a sin run. Everything destroyed. And this is what the wise person does, says this, I got to do it different. I we didn't come here just to hear. We came here to change. And you're going to be the cause, the agent of change by making a decision. I'm done doing life this way. I want change in my life. God, I can't do it. Help me, Jesus, and he will. Right? So now that's where change begins. So I have to decide it. Let's look at this. So ruin. But not only ruin, death also means eternal separation from God. And this is a subject that a lot of people don't like to say in church anymore because we're trying to tickle people's ears. But the truth is, you're going to die. You're going to physically die. And after you physically die, you're going to stand before your creator and you're going to be judged. And if Jesus doesn't save you from your sin now and your addiction now and the cycles of destruction now and you never give your life to Jesus, you'll be separated from God not only here and all his peace and all his joy, but you'll be separated from God forever in a real hell. It's quiet here today. You know what that usually means? There's a lot of truth being spoken. And you know what's happening? We're thinking. Very good. We should be thinking. We should be in this room because this is the most important message you've ever heard. And some of you are trying to go, and I'm not against therapy or anything like that, but some of you guys are trying to go to a therapist to fix what only God can fix. Now, go to a therapist after you, but it's okay, but go to Jesus first.
Let him fix you on the inside, and let's start working on your brain after that. Because we're not here this is not about behavior modification. This is about life transformation. When Jesus came, he didn't say, I've come to change your behavior. He said, I've come to give you an abundant, brand new life. Does anybody want a brand new life with brand new power, change, transformation, and freedom? Praise the Lord. All right, let's keep going. Someone's getting right now some therapy right now. Right? I remember I was working at a not working at a church. I was in a church volunteering. And the pastor he said, "Can you volunteer some hours at the office?" And I was working full-time at a job because but can you come in at the office and volunteer and just take some calls? So I go, yeah, I'll do it. So the first call I got was some lady that wanted counseling. And so I just started talking to her on the phone. And when I talked to her, all my counsel came from the Bible. And I would say, well, you know what? The Bible says this, and the Bible says that, and the Bible says this. She got sick and tired of me. She goes, is that all you got? I just want some therapy. I want some counseling. I need a psychologist. I'm going, I'm trying to give you the Bible, where everybody's getting all their wisdom from anyways. Everything I'm telling you, they're going to tell you, but they're just not going to tell you it came from the Bible. Because any truth that works is spiritual truth. How many understand that? So I was telling her, and she just hung up on me. What she was looking for was for me to relieve her pressure. But God was looking to transform her forever. Come on, does anybody want some transformation? That you could bring your depression and exchange it for Jesus' joy? Come on, you could bring your turmoil within you and have some peace when you leave here. You could bring your addiction and leave with some freedom. You could bring your ruin and get some restoration. That's the God that we serve. Everywhere he goes throughout the world, he restores. He sets people free and he gives people eternal life and he forgives them. Jesus is not here to judge you. He is here to save you. He is here to make you whole. He is here to set you free. He is here to give you a brand new life, and you can have it today. So now, oh, what a miserable person I am. Who will free me from this life that is dominated by sin and death? Good question. Who will free me from this? Do you know a spirit of suicide is a spirit of deception that's telling you that if you kill yourself, you can free yourself. But it's a demon. Are there real devils? Yes. That's why some of you guys like to go to watch those exorcist movies. And you know why you're scared? Because deep down you know this stuff is real. They are real demons. And the crazy thing is, some of you have demons inside of you right now. You don't even know it. And the demons that are inside of you are the thoughts that are constantly dominated and tormenting your mind. And I got good news for you. If you got a thought that's dominated and controlling your mind and it's tormenting you, you could get set free from that because who Jesus sets free is free indeed. Give God some praise. I'm not trying. This is what we're saying. Jesus can do it. Jesus does not come to help you cope. Jesus comes to give you total victory. Old things pass away and everything becomes new. I'm not here to help you survive. I want you to thrive. I want you to overcome. And whatever you're facing right now, with me, we can overcome. How many believe we can overcome with Jesus? We can get restoration. Things can turn around. And the good news is Jesus is bigger than any mistake you've ever made. You know what I love about God? He came for sinners. If you've messed up, like I've messed up, if you've messed up over and over and over, like I've messed up over and over, you qualify for Jesus. Come on. It's just like if you got an accident, you qualify for an ambulance. So you guys, do I have to earn this? You don't have to earn this because Jesus specializes in accidents. Jesus specializes in people that have been cycles of destruction and they can't break it. And what you can't break, he broke. Come on, whatever suffering that you have right now, he suffered for you to give you a total healing and recovery over everything that you're facing. Your best days can be ahead of you. You can forget about the past and start living and pressing towards a high call of God for you, your family, and it can start right now. One encounter with Jesus, it changes everything. Man, this needs to be a series right here. But I love verse 25. You know, we could be stuck on verse 24. What miserable person I am, oh my God. And some of you guys are stuck, and this is what's happening. You tear yourself down over and over. And you know what's so great with the Lord? Even if you've messed up and you've had major losses because of the things that you've messed up in, God can restore all your mess ups with interest. What I mean by that is he can totally restore your life. You can totally recover. He said, man, I lost money. I've lost this. I've lost integrity. He goes, I'll restore it with interest. That means you're not going to miss anything with me because I'm a God that can make up for past mistakes. Aren't you glad that God is bigger than your failures? Bigger than your past. Bigger than your present. So finally, verse 25, I love it. Thank God. I just said it like that because he, exclamation point. He said it like that. Someone got scared, like, oh my God, he's so loud. But when you're desperate and you're depressed and you've gone to every single source that you thought was going to give you release and you went through every relationship, you bought every lotto ticket and you still haven't won nothing. You've gone to the casinos. You've tried every drug. You've tried all kinds of sex and every which way you could do it, and there's still something missing in you. Thank God that the sex can't fix you. Come on. The man can't fix you. The woman can't fix you. The casino can't fix you. The drug can't fix you. But there's a God that can fix you. Thank God there's an answer. Thank God there's a Savior. Thank God we could be forgiven. Thank God we could be set free. Thank God that we could be restored. Thank God that we could receive eternal life. Thank God. Thank God that we could be healed. I love it. I'll say it again. Thank God. Say it with me. Thank God. One more time. Thank God. You know what's so great about this? You know when you say thank you is when you receive something. That's why the devil wants you to be a complainer, because as long as you're a complainer, nothing changes. But there has to be a time in your life that you say, I'm not just here to be a spectator. I'm here to be a participator. And if there's an answer to this, thank God. You know what that means? That you're here, but you're not just hearing. You're receiving something for you and your family, and it starts right now with a thank God. Someone's going to use that. Someone's going to get a shirt. Thank God. And you know, I think this is what happens. We want amazing victory, but we don't want to put any passion into it. Some of us put more passion in supporting our sports team so they can win than supporting your own life so you can win. No wonder we're not getting victory. We're trying to be all like, I don't like to yell. Yeah, right. You know, I just like it quiet. But when you want a victory, come on, you need a real breakthrough. and you tried everything else, and you're finally desperate, and you said something has to give here, and I feel like I'm the one giving, and I feel like I've tried everything, and it's not working. There's a time where Jesus meets you right here, right now, on this Sunday morning, and he said, I didn't bring you here by accident. I brought you here because I have an appointment with you, and I didn't bring you earlier because you weren't ready. This is the time. You know if you don't serve me, it's going to break, and it's going to get worse, but Jesus is saying here, while everybody gave up on you, I've not given up on you, and I'm here to meet you in your misery, not to judge you, but to save you. Give God some praise that he doesn't give up on us. He comes to us at the right time. And this is it. I'll say one more time, I like it. Thank God. Look at this. The answer is in Jesus Christ our Lord. He said, the answer is in Jesus Christ our Lord. Now remember this. The wage of sin is death. That means if you sin, one sin, you've planted a seed of sin, and it'll bring fruit or results, and it'll be death. And this is what Jesus did. He came as a man to pay the price for our sins. And that's why when we sin, we self-destruct and we almost self-sabotage ourselves. And I'll tell you why we self-sabotage ourselves. You have a guilt trip. I messed up. I don't deserve to succeed. I don't deserve good. I don't deserve a break. I'm miserable. Some bad decisions. But Jesus says, I know, but that's why I came. I came to suffer for you, to die for you, and conquer what you couldn't conquer. And if you'll put your faith in me, that's what the cross is all about. All your sins, every sin was put on Jesus. And he says, you no longer need to live under a guilt trip. You no longer need to live under the bondage. You no longer need to live under the misery because I took it all. I took on your sins. I took all the consequences. I took all the rejection. I died in your place. The wage of sin is death. And that's exactly what I did. I died for you in every way so you could live in every way. You could have an exchange. You give me your sin. You give me your misery. You give me your ruin. You give me your addiction. You give me your hell. And I'll give you my life. And I'll give you my freedom. I'll give you my peace. I'll give you my joy. And I'll give you my forgiveness. And I'll give you eternal life. Give God some praise. Thank God. The answer is Jesus Christ. That was the introduction. Now let's get into the preach. I'm just kidding. I mean, it really is an introduction, but this is what I'm going to do. I'll continue this teaching Wednesday. So if you want to more about overcoming the battle within, I'm going to show you even deeper stuff. We're going to go into deeper stuff, how you start winning this battle. But first, you give your life to Jesus. There's a scripture I want to end it with, and it's in Acts 2:38. And it says, Peter replied. They were asking, like, they just heard Peter preaching. Peter's preaching. Someone say he's preaching, like today. And after they heard the preaching, the Bible says their hearts were pierced. Like, I feel that. And then they asked the question, what should we do? Like, we've heard it, but what should we do? What is our action step? How do we participate? How do we get saved? How do we get set free? How do we get restored? How do we receive forgiveness? How do we receive eternal life? How? And then Peter answered this. And he said, each of you, say each. You know what that means? Every one of us must repent of your sins. This is not preached too much in churches either. What's preached today is come to Jesus, but there's only one way for you to come to Jesus. You're gonna have to turn from your sin. Because understand, you can't come to Jesus headed the wrong direction. If you're turning this way, you're walking this way, and you're walking with your sin, and you're walking with the devil, and you're walking in your adultery, and you're walking in your lying, and you're walking in your cheating, and you're walking in all that stuff. You're walking, and then you're cussing, and you're a gangbanger, and you're like, ha! and your pride and your anger, you got to turn and say, I'm done with this life. And then you can now, after you repent of your sins, that means I'm done with that life. I'm done with that life. I'm done with the lying. I'm done with the cheating. I'm done with the addiction. I'm done with the anger. I'm done with the past. I'm done with the cycles of this. I am done with it. Now you turn. Now you turn to God. But you got to turn away from sin and then turn to God. There's two turns. Turn away from sin and then turn to God. But Jesus is not saying, come on. He's not saying this. Just come to me. He's saying, turn from your sins and then come to me. This is what it means. You got to be sick and tired of the way your life is going. I'm not tired yet. Well, then, all right, player, just keep doing it. I see you around because I guarantee you this, life's going to beat you down. And after life beats you down, Jesus is not going to say, I told you. He's going to say, I've been waiting for you. But you know what? Why go through another cycle of that destruction when God is saying right now we can start over and we can start winning, building the winning life that you've been looking for? And it ends with this. It says, repent of your sins and turn to God and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. So he's saying the focus is I'm going to surrender my life into submission to Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is going to be my leader now. Not my sinful nature, not my urges, not my lusts. He's going to be my leader now. And I'm submitted. Baptism means I'm totally submitted to following Jesus. He's my Savior and Lord. And it ends it with this. Be baptized in the name of the Father, of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of sins, then you'll receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Now that's a big deal. This is what it's saying. When you turn to Jesus, he's going to forgive you of your sins, and then he's going to give you a gift. Someone say a gift of the Holy Spirit. You know who the Holy Spirit is? The Holy Spirit is the Spirit of Jesus Christ. The Holy Spirit, another way to say it, is the Spirit of God. Another way to say the Holy Spirit is the power of God. Say it with me, the power of God. Another way to say the Holy Spirit is God. And this is what happens. He goes, when you give your life to Jesus Christ, he'll forgive you of your sins, and then God's Spirit will come and live inside of you. Now, when you know what? Power, the power of God comes and live inside of you. Resurrection power is inside of you. Healing power is inside of you. Come on. Eternal life is inside of you. God, see, you're not joining a religion. And we're not here to change your behavior. We're here to change your life forever. You'll never be the same when God's Spirit moves inside of you. He'll give you new abilities that you never had, new desires you never had. You come the way you are, and then God's Spirit moves in. If someone possessed like the devil can act like the exorcist, imagine if you're possessed by God's Spirit. It'll change your life and your character. What happened to you, Sunday? Oh, what? Your face looks different. What happened? Jesus moved in. His Spirit moved in. I've been set free. I've been made brand new. Let's all stand up where we're at. Let's give the Lord a hand. He's a good God. We're going to dismiss in just a second. We'll dismiss in just a second. I'm going to have Christian close us out. Because I'm in preaching mode right now. I'll just keep preaching. But I want to say this. If this is your first time here, I want to let you know we love you. And all God wants is to give you a life of abundance. In John 10:10, it says this. The thief comes to kill, steal, and destroy. But I've come to give you life in abundance, or a rich and satisfying life. And what he's saying, what you've been looking for is not found in a religion. It's not found in rules. But it's found in a relationship with Christ. And I pray that today, that you will say, okay, Jesus, I feel like Paul. I feel miserable. I feel like I'm doing the things I don't want to do, and the things I don't want to do, I do. I'm all over the place. I don't understand myself, but God understands you. And he said, I'll meet you right where you're at, but you're gonna have to make a decision. Give your life to Jesus. It's a choice. No one accidentally is gonna give their life to Jesus. Jesus intentionally hung on a cross for you. It's gonna be time for you to finally say, I'm ready to give my life to Jesus. And those that say yes is what happens. God's Spirit moves into you and he makes you a brand new person. You won't leave here the same empty person. You will leave here saved, forgiven, you have eternal life, and he'll be living in you. You're one yes away. All he's gonna do is pray with you and ask you for a decision. Don't be ashamed. God's not ashamed of you. He loves you. And I promise you this. This will be the greatest decision you'll ever make. Young people, don't waste your life away. Make your life count. Give your life to Jesus while you're young. Don't wait until you mess up your whole life and then come to Jesus. That's not the best way to learn. Give your life to Jesus. This is what's gonna happen. You're gonna be a leader.
within your peers. They're going to say, man, you're different. You say, yeah. You know what made me different? It was Jesus. He could do it for you too. Imagine being a life changer because God changed your life. What a great way to live. We love you. God loves you. We're going to close out in just a second.
Amen. Come on, can we give God some praise? How many received that word today? How many are ready to win that war, to win that battle within? You know, Pastor Marco already set this up, and you're saying today, I want to be forgiven. I want to give God life. I want to be saved today. And I want to leave here today with a brand new nature. See, until we receive God's Spirit and give our life to Jesus, this battle, we can't win. But once we give our life to Jesus, He's already won the battle, and we're on the winning side. So today, if you want to give your life to Him, and you're saying this, I want to be set free totally. I want to know that I'd leave here saved, born again. And here's a crazy question. Maybe no one has asked you this in a long time or ever. If you were to die today, where would you go? You know what? The moment we die, we take a step into eternity. We have no idea how close personally we probably are to taking that step. It could be moments away, could be years away, but the reality is we just don't know. My encouragement to you, I'm pleading with you, don't gamble with that. Don't play with eternity. You've heard the good news today. You have an opportunity right now to give your life to Jesus because He loves you, He wants to forgive you, and He wants to give you a brand new beginning. Will you accept that today? So if you're saying today, I want to know for sure, if I were to die today, I would not go to hell. I would not be separated from God because of the wrong things I've done, but I'll go to heaven. If you want to know that for sure, here's the answer. It was in the scripture. His name is Jesus Christ. He is the answer to that problem that we're facing. We have sin. We have a price to pay, but Jesus paid the price so that you can be forgiven and have eternal life. So today, if you want to give your life to Jesus, if you want to be forgiven of your sins, and if you want to know for sure that if I were to die today, I'd spend eternity in heaven with God forever, then when I count to three, I want you to raise your hand all over this room. Okay, are we ready? Here we go. One, two, three. Raise your hands all over this room. I see you. I'm proud of you. I see you. I see you. I'm proud of you. I see you, bro. I'm proud of you. I see you back there. Anybody else? I see you right here, man. I see you, bro. I see you right over here. I see you right there. I'm proud of you. I see you over there. Anybody else to my left? I see you. I see you guys. I see all three of you, all four of you right here to my left. I'm proud of you guys. I'm proud of you. Anybody else? Come on. Can we give them a round of applause? Those that raise their hands. I see you back there. I see you back there. I see you. Can you do one more favor for me really quick? There's a team right out here, right off to the side, and right over here to the side in the front. Can you do me a favor? Could you make your way out of your seat and just come up the aisle, and you'll see someone. They're going to greet you right there at the aisle. And what we want to do, we want to congratulate you. We want to connect with you. We want to help you take your next step. Church, let's clap for all those right now that are making their way forward and are making a decision to follow Jesus today. Come on, let's get excited. If you raise your hand, come forward. Come forward. Even if you're out there in the back, come on, let's get excited. Let's get excited.
I trust in God, my Savior.
Man, awesome. Look at, she's coming up right now. Anybody else? You're saying, that's me. I need to be up there. You're saying, I want to give God my everything. I want a new nature. I want to overcome these cycles. I want you to come forward. This is for you. This moment is for you.
Yes.
Come on, they're still coming. Let's give them a hand, guys. They're still coming up. Awesome. This is great. So it's what we're going to do for everybody that just came up. We just want to connect with you. And everyone that just came up, can you look at me for a second? Well, I just want you to know this. We love you so much, and we're going to help you in this walk. We know that this whole thing is new. It's new to everybody at some point. And in that, we want you to know that this walk, this journey, you can do it. Not because we're so amazing, because the reality is in ourselves, we mess up a lot.
You can do it because God is going to empower you, and he's going to walk you through it. He's going to take you by the hand, and he's going to be there every step of the way. In the mountaintops, in those low valleys, every step, Jesus will never, ever leave you or forsake you or abandon you, and he's got you. And so do we. We're going to be right here with you. So we have classes that are set up for you. They're called Holy Warriors. The person in front of you, they're going to pray with you, and then they're going to open the app, and they're going to help you get signed up for this next step. This is your next step. It's Holy Warriors. What's our next step? That's our next step. So we're going to pray with you, and we're going to get you signed up for your next step. But let's pray. Let's pray. Everyone bow your heads and repeat after me. Say, Jesus, thank you for going to the cross for me. You paid a price that I should have paid because I sinned and you never did. But thank you, Jesus, for loving me enough to sacrifice your life so that I can be saved. I believe you died. I believe you resurrected from the dead so that I can be forgiven. So from this moment forward, I give my life to you. Fill me with your Holy Spirit. Give me a brand new nature. And right now, I surrender every bondage, all addiction, all depression, all anxiety, all fear, all suicidal thoughts, everything I've been dealing with. I put it at your feet, Jesus, and I give it to you. And fill me now with your love and your power and your goodness. Thank you, Lord. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. We say amen and amen. Awesome, yeah. Come on, let's give God some praise. So we love you. Don't forget, the Pomona Crossroads drama is still happening tonight. They added some more tickets on the app. So if you weren't able to get tickets for tonight, jump on. There's probably like, I don't know, a couple dozen left maybe. I have no idea. But they just added some rows. So now's your chance if you want to go check that out. We love you so much. God bless you. And if you need any prayer, come forward. We would love to pray with you. God bless you. Have a wonderful Sunday. Remember, if God is for you, there's no one who can come against you. Don't miss this Wednesday. Pastor Marco's doing...